and welcome to the QSC K.2 Series Firmware Update Tutorial video. To perform this procedure, you'll need a micro USB cable and a Windows-based computer. So make sure you have both of these things handy before you begin. First, however, you'll need to check the current version that is installed on your loudspeaker against what is currently available on the QSC website. To view the current firmware, power the loudspeaker on. Now select Settings on the display menu to view the current firmware version that is installed. If the firmware version displayed is below 1.2.0, an update is required. If the firmware version displayed is version 1.2.0 or later, no update is necessary. Now, if your loudspeaker does require updating, go ahead and move on to our first step and begin the update process. First, navigate to the QSC website. Next, click Resources at the top of the page. Then, select Software and Firmware on the Resources page. After that, click K.2 Series Firmware Updater to access the download page, followed by selecting the Download Firmware Update button to begin the download. Depending on your browser, you may need to specify a save location to download it to. If you're not sure where to save it, just save it to your desktop. Some browsers will automatically save it to the Downloads folder. Once the updater zip has been successfully downloaded, you'll need to unzip or unarchive it. You may need an unarchiving utility to do this, and if you don't have one, a simple web search will yield a few options. Many of them are free and really easy to use. In the Destination folder, run the K2 updater install file to start the updater setup. Follow the on-screen instructions to read and accept the end user license agreement, then select the destination folder for the program files and click Next. Continue until the software installation is complete. Be advised, this update procedure only takes about 2 minutes to complete. However, once you start the update, you must let it continue without interruption. An interruption at this stage where the firmware is writing into the module will corrupt the firmware and prevent the loudspeaker from powering up. So make sure that the USB to micro USB cable will not be disconnected, even accidentally, and that the loudspeaker will not be turned off. Okay, let's begin the update procedure. Start with the amplifier module turned off. On the computer, open up the K2 updater application. On the rear of the speaker, carefully remove the knob off the rotary encoder on the loudspeaker's amplifier module. You will see a micro USB port next to the rotary encoder. Plug the cable into the port and plug the other end into an available USB port on the computer. Now, turn the amplifier module on. The K2 updater application should discover and identify the K.2 loudspeaker connected to the computer and display it in a table. Click Update to start the process. The update from start to finish typically takes under 2 minutes. A progress bar will display the update status in the K2 updater application. At the same time, the loudspeaker LCD screen will also show the progress of the new firmware loading into the loudspeaker's internal memory. This transfer of the new firmware from the computer into the loudspeaker internal memory is part of the update process that will take the most time. When the update is complete, the message "Firmware is up to date" will appear. After the firmware has been loaded into the loudspeaker's internal memory, the amplifier module will write it into the permanent firmware. It only takes about 3 or 4 seconds, but is absolutely critical that this step has no interruption. Never shut off the loudspeaker when the display indicates writing firmware. Once this process is complete, turn off the loudspeaker and disconnect the USB micro cable and press the knob back onto the rotary encoder shaft. Turn the loudspeaker on. Booting up will take a few seconds. On the Configuration display menu, select Settings and verify that the display shows the correct model number and the current version firmware. The update is now complete and the loudspeaker is ready to be used again. If for some reason the update did not complete during the loading process, for example, if the progress bar had frozen before the loading was completed, start over by turning the loudspeaker off for a couple of seconds and then on again. Then click Update in the K2 Updater application once it recognizes the loudspeaker again. Just one quick note before I sign off. QSC recommends keeping the update setup as simple and direct as possible, doing one loudspeaker at a time to reduce the chance of an error or mishap. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.